She has turned heads on the Logies red carpet with outfits that really push fashion to its limits. No doubt Susie Elelman will be doing the same on Sunday when the TV Awards are on again. She's here to show us some of her most famous outfits from the Logies. Susie, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
It has been said by some very unkind people that you've made a career out of red carpet shockers, but I reckon you're brave.
Yeah.
And fun. Isn't fashion supposed to be fun?
Well, I think it isn't, particularly on red carpets. That's what people are expecting. Now you've got stylists who get all these celebrities and they're perfection from top to toe. And it's lost it. We saw the Met Ball the other... And all of those avant-garde... Yeah. You used to get that on every red carpet. Now... The Met Ball's
the
only thing.
Who remembers what people wear these days, you know?
No, exactly right. And, yes, I've had some scathing publicity, as you do, but being referred to as the Cher of Australia, although there was really one beaute one, the one of the outfits, which we'll talk about a little later on, and I'll describe how it was described to me.
Well, we've got a heap of your dresses here.
Wow.
Now, which one is your absolute favourite?
Well, I think the one that Jess is holding up there, of course, would go on her twice.
I love you.
That's gorgeous. That was one of the ones that my current designer, Peter Bartlett, made for me, which is absolutely stunning. I adore that. So that's my favourite of Peter Bartlett's ones.
Lots of Hollywood tape, though, Susie.
No Hollywood tape,
none.
Jess.
How
you
does
feel,
it stay
no,
there?
It's all to do with posture. My mother always taught me shoulders back so that these sit on your rib cage.
And may I just say, they are excellent, by the way.
Yeah.
That was last year's Logies?
No, that's a few years ago now. I lose track of the time.
This is so pretty.
This is a Lisa Ho, and that's only gorgeous. Time I've ever made it on the best dress list at the Logies.
And how did you feel in it?
Were you disappointed?
It's a beautiful
Was I disappointed?
Dress.
Well, it was kind of nice to right the wrong. You know, I've been on the worst dress list enough times, it's nice to sort of balance that scale. Occasionally.
And it's got some good support.
Oh, Jess,
too.
Now you're showing all the bits that you're not supposed to.
And that's what people want to see,
I think. Yeah. That's important. What people don't realise is that every single Logies dress of mine has been made to measure.
Yeah.
So what
I remember this one.
Wow.
Yeah.
Strategic.
This one.
Yes.
Strategic indeed, yes.
So do you wear anything under?
No,
like
nothing
slip
worn under
see,
that.
No. No, she wears nothing under
well,
it.
Well, Denise and I are at the same table last year. So it's really interesting when people look at you and where they look.
Where they look.
So no undies either?
No, Jess.
Oh. What's next?
Look at this with the bag and everything.
Yes, he made the bag. That's another Peter Bartlett
number.
Oh,
I love it.
Which was stunning. Because, you know, colour's really important on the red carpet as well.
Yeah.
But the three ones that are on the mannequins, which I think are really the sort of the three that I'm most infamous for, are all Christopher Essex designs.
Oh,
and of course,
he's brilliant.
Oh, he's incredible. Sadly, we lost him in 2008. But that is my all-time favourite, the one that Jess has
made. Do you have a good story about that dress?
Well, when Christopher made it, he made the bodysuit first, and then he stood me up in it, and then you can imagine the first two of those black things he placed.
Wow.
And then he worked from there. I didn't exhale all night in that.
But Susie, sorry, just looking close up at this, I mean, it's exquisite, but, like, it's nothing. It's
correct.
Transparent.
Don't lift that up, Jess. Not a wise move.
No, they're little undies, though. Like, it's a little...
It's a bodysuit. So what he's done is he's made the bodysuit and then he's put the skirt over it and then that... Yeah. Yeah.
This is... I remember this. You did a wonderful reveal on the red carpet.
I did. I shaved my head.
Oh.
It was... I was turning 50. And 7 or 8 years before I turned 50, I said to myself, no matter what you're doing, you're going to shave your head at 50. If you're in television and you get invited to the Logies, lucky enough, you'll do it then.
Why did you want to do that?
Because I've been going grey since I was 16, 17. I had more grey hairs at 21 than my mum had at 71 when she passed away. And I thought, I'm going to be like Rowena Wallace. I'm going to have this gorgeous silver hair. Bop bomb. Oh. You know how they talk about mousy brown hair? It was rat grey.
Oh, no. So it was liberating.
It was so liberating. It was unbelievable. But that was the reveal. Now, if Jess, I don't know if you can spin that dress around, but if you look at the back of it, it was all backless. But again, I'm not someone that can go without a bra. So that is so much construction in that, it's beyond belief. But look what he did on the back of it and on the front of it, all of that diamantes and everything. Amazing. It's just exquisite. It
is. And just the last dress.
This is like Halle Berry's
one. It is like Halle Berry's.
Isn't it?
Again, Christopher took every single flower and sewed, hand sewed it on, and even put leaves at the back to cover up the zipper. So no matter where, which area I was photographed, front, back, side,
beautiful,
you would never ever see any of the mechanics.
Wow.
Now, I want to donate these to the Powerhouse Museum because they are just too exquisite.
They're one off.
They are.
Exactly.
You're right, Denise.
Yes, they're
and
fabulous. That wonderful man has gone.
Oh, he has. It's so tragic. Yeah. But you know, you've missed one out.
Oh, this pinky one.
Yeah,
this
one.
No.
Who? Oh, no, that I know.
Let's
the worst dressed on that
the one.
One
that we've missed out on.
Let's the black and white one that was.
Where is
most,
that?
Let's have a little curls, didn't it?
Well, I was described.
Dressed by Spunk Rat of South Yarra. Paul's done this. He's built everything up at the front, and there's a lot going on down here as well.
This was your idea, Susie. This was your idea.
I must say, I will confess, it was my idea. I thought, if anyone's going to fit into this now, it's going to be Jono.
I'm having a baby! A little Logie baby.
Jono looks better in that than I did.
Oh, a little less cleavage on Jono.
Can I tell you that I was describing... No, do you know, that's the one I had that Peter Bartlett remade when I turned 60. That's the original. And I tell you what, there's more construction in that than the Sydney Harbour Bridge, let me tell you.
I can feel it.
But I was described...
A lot of people are going to want to walk you.
Ask me more.
I was described as a herd of zebras rampaging down the red carpet in that one.
But a beautiful herd of zebras.
Now, make sure you do get your copy of New ID magazine to check out Susie's weight loss story as well. Susie, what are you wearing to this year's Logies? Can you tell us?
It's going to be black and silver this year, is all I can tell you.
Dramatic.
And Peter Bartlett has excelled himself again.
Again.
Oh, yeah.
I love the confidence you have. You're so much fun to watch. Thanks for being on our show.
Yay. Thanks, love you.